So these easy-to-write finite state machines that we've been using that involve epsilon transitions or ambiguity, remember ambiguity means that I can go to two different places on the same input, are formally known as non-deterministic finite state machines. Non-deterministic here just means that you may not know exactly where to go or where to put your finger. It's not lockstep. You have choices. You have freedom. A lockstep finite state machine with no epsilon transitions and no ambiguity, by contrast, is called a deterministic finite state machine. Everything is determined from the start. Given the finite state machine and the input, you always know exactly what will happen. Our finite state machine simulation procedure can handle deterministic finite state machines. That makes them really useful for implementing regular expressions under the hood. Let me just show you an example of this non-determinism, just to drive it home. Suppose we're back here in this previous finite state machine, but now the input is 1-2-3. Where are we? Well, we started here, and on a 1, we went here, and then I guess if we're supposed to stay alive and there's a hyphen, we must have gone here and taken the hyphen. And now there's a 2, but now this is really not obvious. I could stay here on this self loop for a 3, or I could have gone back on this free epsilon transition and done the self loop here on a 3, so I could be in state 2 or state 5. Since there isn't one single answer for where I could be, this is non-deterministic. As a bit of a fun aside, this notion of determinism, or non-determinism, can be related to the question of free will in philosophy. Can we actually make independent choices, or is everything preordained by the current state of the world and forces acting on it, like a lockstep game of billiard or snooker or pool? Some philosophers will approach this by suggesting that we have the illusion of free will, that's a disconcerting thought, which is handy for describing subjective experience. We certainly often feel like we have free will. Regardless of what's going on in the real world, we're going to see that something similar holds for finite state machines. Although non-deterministic finite state machines look like they have much more power and much more freedom, anything that could be done with them could also be done in our deterministic billiard ball world. In fact, you can watch me suck free will out of this world right now. Every non-deterministic finite state machine has a corresponding deterministic finite state machine that accepts exactly the same strings. Non-deterministic finite state machines are not any more powerful than deterministic finite state machines. They're just more convenient. It's easier to write them down. Let's see an example of this extraordinary claim. Suppose we have this regular expression. There are only two strings in the language of this regular expression, but here I've drawn out a very elaborate finite state machine for it that has epsilon transitions coming out the wazoo. This is very non-deterministic. We definitely need to see an A, but then here these two epsilon transitions represent the explicit choice, do I do the B or do I skip over it? In the top road, we need to see the B. On the bottom road, we skip entirely past it, and then in any event, we need to see the C. I'm now going to write a deterministic finite state machine that does exactly the same thing. And I'm going to hint at how this conversion works. We'll see this again in just a minute. After I see an A, I could be in 2, or I could take the epsilon to 3. I could have taken the epsilon down here to 6, or all the way over to 4. So there are 4 places I could be in. That's a lot of fingers. I'll just record all of them as the name for my new state, 2, 3, 6, 4. From here, if I see a B and I survive, remember finite state machines work if there's any path that gets to the end, it must have been that I was in state 3, at which point now I'm just in state 4. By contrast, if I was back here and I saw a C, it must have been that I was in state 4 and now I'm in state 5. And then finally, if I'm in state 4 and I see a C, I end up here. So this deterministic finite state machine accepts the same language as the one above. The two strings, A, B, C, and AC, are both in it. But it does not have epsilon transitions or ambiguity. In any particular node, there are never two edges going out labeled A, and there are never epsilon transitions. Let's see another example of how this works. Again, I'm going to build a deterministic machine where every state in the deterministic machine corresponds to a set of states in the non-deterministic one. Again, to restate that, you give me a non-deterministic machine, I'm going to build you a deterministic machine D that accepts the same language. And the way I'll do it is, every state in D is going to correspond to a set of states in the non-deterministic machine you gave me.